So the time now is 10 past 9. Flight leaves at 12:50, so we're doing pretty good for time. Really got to stop looking at cameras. So we literally just had to run to our gate. Apparently it was closing in 2 minutes time. We just made it. There was a big queue anyway. Finally got in. We were told the plane's broken. Reassuring. Right, so a lot has happened since I last turned on this camera. We had an issue with the car rental company. So what they've done to rectify their big screw up is the compact car that we initially rented, the small four-door hatchback, has received a bit of an upgrade. Look at that 4x4 SUV beast. So it's the start of day one here in Switzerland, and we've got no plans really, because everything from this point onwards was all planned in France. We were supposed to be there by now. But with the car rental company issue, we're having to stick it in Switzerland for a bit longer, which isn't that bad of a thing really. I can think of far worse places to be stuck. So the unplanned plan for today is to go to a place called Interlaken, which is the other side of Geneva Lake from where we are, and it looks really nice. Right, let's do it. So we've just this minute arrived at Interlaken, and this place is absolutely stunning. There's mountains surrounding the whole area. The only issue is, even though it's stopped raining now, or it's almost stopped raining, there's quite a lot of cloud cover. So I'm hoping the clouds will lift soon, but there's a lake just around the corner from here, and you can see some of the mountain, some of the base of the mountain. So I'm hoping to go over there now and try and get a good photo. Right, it's definitely nothing to do with cameras, but I'm in a Patagonia store, and the stuff here is ridiculously cheap, especially compared to UK prices. And everything's on sale as well, so I'm really tempted. What do you think? It's not my ideal colour, but it's so damn cheap. I didn't do it. I couldn't do it. It was cheaper than it would have been in the UK, but I've got enough jackets. So we've made it to one of the lakes. Oh my goodness. It's nice. It's very hazy. The clouds starting to lift as well, but it's still quite hazy and there's a lot of movement in the water. But we'll see what we can get here. It's lovely. Okay, so I've set up for my first shot here. What I'm going for is a bit of foreground symmetry with some of the mountain in the background. And because there's quite a lot of movement in the water at the moment, I'm not intending to get too much of that in. So I've got these, I'm not sure what you call them, these little, not jetties, but these things with handrails on. I've got these in the foreground for symmetry. So my setup here, I've got a circular polarizing filter on. And just in the foreground here, there's a puddle of water. And around the puddle of water is quite a bit of glare. So as you can see here in the video, that's with the circular polarizer off. And if I rotate this around, you'll see that the glare in the puddle there, a lot of it starts to go. So what I'm gonna do, I'm exposing for the center. So I'm exposing for this dark area here. So that means the sky and the top of the mountains are quite overexposed. And even though the clouds in the background are quite thick, and they are just pretty much white from what I can see here, I'm gonna try and expose for them as well, and then merge the two exposures together in Photoshop. We'll see if we can recover some of the details from the clouds, but there's not much, but we'll give it a go. Okay, so I'm just lining up my second shot here at this lake, and I've gone for a reflection photo. So I've got those houses lined up over there, and you can see the reflections just underneath them. And where the houses meet the reflection, how rude is that? Oh, no, don't go for that.
We've got a daredevil.
I don't know. Oh, well, it's safe. Okay. Yeah, so where the reflections meet up with the houses, I've got that lined up on the bottom horizontal line of the ruler thirds composition. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set my aperture probably to about f11 or f13. And I'm going to see in aperture priority mode what it determines the shutter speed will be at ISO 100. And put a 10 stop on there and calculate the adjustment for the shutter speed once the 10 stops on. I just want to remove as much of these ripples in the lake as possible. Yeah, I think it will come out okay. Right, so the light's starting to dip here now and the mountain's clearing over there. I want to see if we can go further down the other side of the lake and see if we can get a clearer shot of those mountains there in the background. Right, so we've made it here and the light is perfect. Oh my goodness. The light is just amazing. The sun's just gone behind those mountains over there. And the mountains are turning a lovely, lovely colour of blue. And we've got this lake here. Oh my goodness, the reflections are beautiful. Let me see if I can show you. So, I don't know if you can gauge here, but I can't walk anywhere closer than where I am really at the moment. It looks like it just sinks straight down into that lake. So, I'm gonna have to set up my camera somewhere here, but look for a good composition at the same time. You know what, I've changed my mind. I'm leaving the camera equipment here for a second and I'm going down to see just how close I can get. That was a no-go. I was this close to almost falling completely into that lake. So I'm gonna take a walk around, see if there's any better position. And I think I've found it. You see, just a little bit of persistence and patience and all it took was, what, a 20 meter walk? So I've just been shouting for Fran. She's over there reading a book and she's told me that I might actually be in someone's garden. And if I am in that garden, that is the house there, which is absolutely massive. So I'm gonna be a bit quieter with this one, but the shot here is absolutely amazing. So I've got my tripod set to as high as it can go, just so I can overlook all of these little blades of grass or these big blades of grass. I'm actually going to do a bracketed shot again here, just so I can recover some of the details from the clouds. And I'm composing my picture with the reflection running straight through the center of the frame. So let's see how this one goes. Now to go before anyone sees me. So it looks like that's all the pictures we're gonna get today. Now, we just need to figure out where we're sleeping.
Look at the size of it.
Okay, so this six bed hostel, I'm on the top bunk by the way, is just for the two of us. But this is, oh, and the view's not bad as well. Just can't wait for those clouds to clear. Hopefully tomorrow, it'll be a little bit better. So the idea is today to get on a train here in Interlaken, which goes up the side of a mountain. And when I say up the side of a mountain, I mean literally up the side of a mountain. The incline is ridiculous. I'm gonna put the name of the train up in the top. So the idea is to go up there, get some nice sweeping panoramas, and hopefully the clouds will lift up enough for us to be able to do that. And have a look here at these tiles.
just surrounded by them. They're absolutely awful. It's like something out of the 1940s.
So we received a tip-off from a local about this place called the Metropole Hotel. It's an 18-storey hotel, and right at the top of it is a restaurant which people don't often come to unless they're staying in the hotel here. But it's open to anyone. You don't have to have a room in the hotel here to eat at this restaurant. But what this person mentioned is that not many people are aware of that. And she was right. There's just the two of us. And what I've got lined up here is a shot using a long stretch of the main road. It's quite a straight main road. I'm using it as a leading line, drawing the eyes of the viewer up towards the mountains in the background. Unfortunately, the mountains in the background, they do have some cloud cover at the top, but there are some peaks that we can see. So let's see how this one goes. That's quite nice. I think that will look better in black and white.
So there it is. There's the track there, going up all the way straight up there.
That is ridiculous.
Thanks.
Okay, so I think I finally found something. I've got in the bottom left-hand corner of my rule of thirds composition, a chalet or a hotel. And leading up to that, I've got a nice row of trees, and I've got my lens set to 80mm, which is compressing a nice mountain range in the background there. Snow-topped mountains with clouds just covering the tips. And what I'm gonna do an exposure stack as well. The clouds at the top are quite white, and I wanna retain some of the detail on the top of the mountains, as well as all of the shadows down here near the trees. Right, let's see how it goes. We're gonna miss the train. We've got like 2 minutes. We've been told by another local that there's apparently a really big waterfall around here. It's in a place called, is it Lauderbrunnen, yeah. So we're trying to find this waterfall. So I think it's about a 10-minute drive away. So we've taken a snack break from finding this waterfall, and I thought I'd use this as an opportunity to speak to those of you out there who have been looking at some of my videos, some of my photos, and the accounts of other people on Instagram, Flickr, and YouTube and that, and you've been thinking to yourself, I really want to be able to do that, but I'm just not good enough, or it's all about the camera and I haven't got the money to buy the equipment, so there's just no point. The best camera, and this is something that loads of people have said, but the best camera is the one you have on you. You don't need to have a £1,000 camera. My camera is relatively inexpensive compared to professionals out there. I'm not a professional. And I'm taking the photos that I'm taking based on experience through learning, trial and error, and my photos at the start just turned out pretty awful. And I got disheartened because I was looking at other people's accounts, looking in awe of all of these photos that I wish I could take. And a year and a half, 2 years down the line, I'm taking photos that I never thought I'd be able to take, and you can do it. It's not that hard. You've just got to learn, and that's the exciting part about it. So take the leap, it's worth it, I promise you. So we found the waterfall and I've set up for my shot. I'll show you the waterfall up there. And I'm going to compose the image with the waterfall just to the right of the frame. I'm going for a vertical shot. And there's a cemetery down here as well. So I'm going to get some of the cemetery heads, some of the gravestones in, and see if we can get the waterfall. Just slow it down slightly just to smoothen out that water. Okay, now this one is completely spontaneous. We're just going back to the hostel after getting something to eat, and the light's starting to drop, and we just noticed down there, I think it's a dam or a hydro station or something. Now what really caught my eye about it are the mountains immediately behind it, and also the white water in front. And also the water is a really, really, really nice shade of aqua. So what I've chosen for this one really quickly is I've got no filters on whatsoever, an aperture of f11, and that's given me a shutter speed of about 2 seconds. Now that should be plenty of time to somewhat smoothen out the water without taking away its character completely. If I was going for a shutter speed of about 3 or 4 seconds plus, then the water would be way too smooth and I'm going to lose all of those white rapids up the top there. So unless we come past anything else that I want to shoot and just have to shoot, that's pretty much it for today. And tomorrow we might go up a cable car somewhere or possibly go hiking somewhere a bit remote, somewhere where there aren't a lot of people. So until then, see you tomorrow. So before we can do anything today, I need to buy myself some sort of external mass storage. I knew I was going to run out of space sometime, and I was this close to buying one in the UK, but I considered it so late that there was no guarantees it was going to be delivered on time. And there's no way whatsoever I'm going to be buying it in a high street shop because the prices are just ridiculous compared to buying it on somewhere like Amazon. The good thing is though, where we're staying here in Interlaken, I researched some computer shops here and they're actually cheaper here than they are in the UK, even on somewhere like Amazon. And if that isn't enough, the particular type of storage I want is a Samsung SSD, and this particular shop has all Samsung products with 10% off for the next week or something, so perfect timing. Okay, this is something I haven't seen before. Now we're talking. That's the one. Look at that. We wanted to get this for such a long time. And it ended up about £60-65 cheaper than in the UK. So, what a touch. So we're in a place called Grindelwald, which sounds like something out of Harry Potter, and we just got out of the hiking slash cable car place, and it's bad news unfortunately. A lot of the routes are going to be closing soon due to the weather. It just started chucking it down outside, and the lady, the very nice lady behind the counter, she also suggested that we didn't go hiking up those same routes today because of an avalanche risk. So that's something to bear in mind, isn't it? So unfortunately a bit of a downer today. There's not really much happening. With the weather as it is, it looks like we can't really do too much. We're gonna have to pretty much take a literal rain check on today. Just started raining again for like the 10th time today. And we haven't really been able to walk for longer than 20 minutes without it starting up again. And again, and again. But yeah, it's just been pretty relentless. It's just not meant to be really, is it? But it's not meant to be, it's just not meant to be. So we're on our way to a place called Lucerne, which is about an hour away from Interlaken. We're about halfway there now, and as you can see, we came across this stunning view. So I've set up my camera here, and I'll run you guys through the composition I've chosen. So the most obvious composition for this one might be just to shoot straight through the center of the lake, capturing what's on both sides as well as the foreground and background. But to me, there's a bit too much going on. It's a bit too messy. I'm going just to the right side of the lake, capturing these houses in the bottom and also the mountains in the background. I'm capturing all of these trees in the foreground just to add a lot more depth to the image. So we've just arrived here in Lucerne, and the first thing that's caught our eyes, as you can see behind me, is that bridge in that tower, and it's known as the Chapel Tower or Chapel Bridge, and it's quite an iconic monument here in Lucerne. And the initial composition that I wanted to go for was incorporating both of where these barriers meet. But the issue with that was where the tripod needed to be placed was on a bridge itself, and every time a car drove past or someone walked near the tripod, it incorporated way too much shape. And my intention for this is to get a long exposure because the people in the far distance near the tower, I want them completely blurred out. So over there in the corner is where I took my last shot, and it seems as if as soon as I rocked up to that place, hundreds of people decided to go there as well. And an hour later, as soon as I decide to leave, they've all seemed to have left as well. So we can't really win, but we've got to move on, see if there's anything else here we can shoot. So not much else happened yesterday, really. We didn't... In fact, that's a lie. Something did happen. Something really big actually happened. I know it's bad, but I've given in.
Your receipt.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Have a good time.
Don't judge me. So back to what I was saying, in terms of photography, there hasn't been much that happened. However, we were in a city yesterday and I find it quite hard to be inspired by any city. So we ended up just chilling, we had some food, and we ended up driving quite far down south to a place that you can get a cable car about 2,000 meters up into one of the mountains, and we're just gonna go for it. We're just gonna try our luck and just see what we can get. So we've dropped our stuff off at the hotel. Oh, I'm knackered. We've been walking now for about 40 minutes non-stop and the light's fading quite quickly. So we're only probably gonna get to do one more video. So I better make it a good one. So I think I've got it. I've got my camera set up here in what seems to be about a foot's worth of snow. And just behind me, there's a huge, huge mountain range. There are some trees in the mid-ground, and in the foreground here, we've got some snow and some grass just peeking itself in. So what I'm doing is I'm compressing this whole section here. I'm trying to compress as much as I can. The snow, the grass, the trees, and the mountains without losing any of them. So the idea with me wanting to compress them as much as possible is to make that mountain range there look even more monstrous. I need another hand. Yes. What an end to a holiday.